Hello students, today we are going to take up the topic that is chemical reactions. So in this topic what we are going to discuss is what is the meaning of chemical reaction. Chemical reaction is a change. Which type? It is a chemical change. And chemical change, we mean to say that the new products are formed. That's one of the characteristics. And some change we can observe. Observe means in terms of what? In terms of some, let us say, color change, in terms of precipitation, and there may be some energy changes taking place. Energy changes means to say that when you react two reactants, when you combine two reactants, there may be evolution of heat or absorption of heat. The temperature of the solution may increase or temperature of solution may decrease. So these are the changes taking place whenever chemical reaction takes place. So let us move forward. If we see that we are having an egg and you have converted into omelette. So now you cannot revert it back. Like omelette again cannot be converted into an egg. So this means that there is the absorption of energy, that's one. Second thing is it is not reversible. Okay, so that change may not be reversible. Some changes are reversible also. For example, let us say the reaction is there, Hebbers process. That is equilibrium reaction, means that it can go to reactant left or right. Okay, depending upon the temperature conditions. Okay, so now next thing is chemical reaction releases energy. Energy in the form of what? Energy in the form of heat. Energy in the form of light. For example, any burning reaction is there. So light and heat both will be released. For example, any reaction relating to the crackers, firecrackers, sound is produced. So these are all good. And somewhere you will see that when you burn something, when you heat something, the noise is coming. So this also are the characteristic of chemical reaction. Moving forward to the next area, like for example rocket fuel. So you know that rocket, once the ignition started and once the propellant is burned, immediately it can leave the periphery of the earth's surface and it move to the sky, or it will leave the atmosphere surface of the earth and it move to another planet or in the space. So means to say that the reaction is very very fast or very instantaneous reaction. Very fast changes taking place. Okay, so this propellant based reactions are a very fast reaction. So rate of reaction is also one of the characteristics. So the next is, let us say if you are having the rusting of iron, so that is a very very slow. It can take place in a 1 month, it can take place in 1 year, it can be take place in 10 years. So this rate of reaction is very slow. In some reaction will be very slow, some reaction will be very fast. For example, acid and base can react, immediately salt is formed. So that is reaction is very fast reaction. Okay. So similarly, chemical reactions are also in our body also, it is taking place. How? Like for example, if we see that chemical reactions, cataplasm and metabolism is there. Cataplasm and metabolism. This is taking place under the bioenzyme. That bioenzymes are there. Bioenzymes are there in our body that helps in completing that reactions. So which helps, for example, digestion of food. Okay, digestion of proteins, carbohydrates, vitamins. So that are related with the biochemical reactions by the presence of enzymes that are known as biocatalysts. Similarly, chemical reactions, so the scientists are constantly working to find new kind of chemical reactions in order to produce new substances, the useful products, new discoveries, new inventions. That is taking place when you try new chemical reactions. Okay. Similarly, if you see chemical reaction, if reaction is there only, it means reactant is converted to product. Along with that, change taking place, change characteristic we have discussed, like temperature may increase or decrease, light may absorb or release, the sound may absorb or release, so the state may change. So these are the characteristic, like color may change, the precipitation may take place. So these are the physical properties like this will change, like color, texture, state, density and solubility. Earlier, for example, substance was not soluble, now it is soluble. Or earlier it was in solution form, now it is in precipitate form. Similarly, melting point. Earlier melting point was less. Let us say water was there, melting point was less. If you add one sugar there, melting point increases, boiling point increases. So the means to say that the characteristic property will get changed. So chemical properties, if you see that combustibility and the substance can be combustible. If you see glass, glass cannot be burned, cannot be combustible. Like similarly, HCl gas, that is not combustible, hydrogen is combustible. Corrosion, corrosion can take place for highly reactive metals, it may not be possible for platinum gold. Similarly, reaction with acid, somewhere reaction with acid is very fast, and similarly bleaching ability. Bleaching means characteristic of like sulfur dioxide is acting as bleaching agent, and that is temporary bleaching, and ozone is permanent bleaching is there. Okay, so this chlorine is also permanent bleaching agent is there. So this way the properties are changing. So properties means that it special, it is giving some description. Description means it acts as an adjective. Similarly, change. Change describes the what is done. So it means it is correlated with the verb. Okay. So physical change, you know already that physical properties will change, but the chemical properties will not change. Like state of matter can change, physical property, color can change. So these are physical properties. Chemical property means the chemical transformation takes place. Chemical transformation means to say that new bonds are formed. New bonds are formed means to say that the old bonds are broken. So this way we have to do further task. Okay. So physical and chemical change we have already discussed. I am not going into that detail because physical state will change and form will change. And chemical change, you know that the new substance will be formed. The properties will change for the products. Okay. So the next is regarding the color, like precipitate. For example, this lead, let us say we are having a lead nitrate solution and you are adding KI you are adding. So lead iodide will be formed, that is having yellow PPT. So this is the type of reaction where color is changing, precipitates are formed. So along with that, heat or light, like fire reactors, light is generated, heat is generated. So these are the chemical reactions. And for example, production of gas, like for example, we are reacting magnesium with the hydrochloric acid, so you know that hydrogen gas will release, with the bubbles will be there. So this represents the change. Okay. Similarly, the chemical equation, the chemical equation is what? It changes reactant into product. This we have done in chapter number 1 previously. So I would just touch upon the another topic that is there presently. So this is chemical reaction. Chemical reaction means the reaction is the process of breaking of bonds. Means all the bonds are broken and new bonds are formed. And whenever bonds we are going to break, the energy is required. And whenever the bonds are formed, the energy is released. If the energy released is more than the energy required to break the bond, the reaction will be exothermic. And if the energy released in forming the bond is less as compared to the energy required in breaking the bonds, so it means the reaction will be endothermic. So this decides the reaction is exothermic or endothermic. Similarly, chemical bond is the force of attraction which binds two atoms in a molecule or in a compound. If you are talking about a molecule like hydrogen, H2. So this is a molecule. Hydrogen is having covalent bond. Similarly, if you are talking about water, water is having compound. So water, hydrogen, oxygen bonds are there to bond. So for breaking that, similar to that carbon dioxide also, this is a compound. So we should be clear about molecule, we should be clear about homoatomic, heterotomic, and we should be clear about the compound. Okay, all these fundamental concepts you should be very clear. So what is the condition necessary for chemical change? So chemical change to take place, the two reactants should be in close contact. So for example, you want to make HCl and you want to combine H2 and Cl2. If you are not combining, how HCl will form? The means to say that close contact is required. Similarly, iron sulfide is we want to prepare. Iron and sulfur, if you kept separately, how the iron sulfide will form? When you combine together, when you heat together, then only the black solid will be formed, iron sulfide. Similarly, I want to treat acid and base, I want that salt NaCl is formed. So how NaCl will form if you not combine that? So contact is important along with that. If you take NaOH, NaOH solid you will take and HCl is in gas. If you try to contact, then salt may not be formed. So you have to convert NaOH solid into aqueous first, and HCl gas also into hydrochloric acid liquid. So then you combine. So it means that we need to convert into the specific state of matter to reaction, for a reaction to take place. Otherwise reaction may not be fast or may not be feasible, or it may not take place. Similarly, some reactions require heat, like the breaking of copper carbonate to copper oxide. So please remember this color, very important. Copper carbonate is green in color, copper oxide is black in color, and carbon dioxide, you know that colorless, odorless gas with effervescence is there. Here might not come because here no acid we are added. Now next is light. Some reactions taking place in the presence of light, and whenever decomposition takes place in the light, that is known as photolysis. Okay, and so sunlight is there, carbon dioxide water is absorbed, and glucose and oxygen is formed. So this is the basis of our life, which life depends on. Okay, so the next is laxity. We're passing the laxity, the decomposition takes place. Water is decomposing into hydrogen and oxygen by the presence of A, passing the laxity, as well as catalyst is also there, like now. So here hydrogen is cathode, oxygen is anode. So hydrogen, both are gases we have decomposed. Okay, we have decomposed water into hydrogen and oxygen. Similarly, pressure. Pressure is high pressure, means to say 200 atmosphere pressure is required to convert nitrogen and hydrogen to ammonia. So this reaction is also exothermic. Okay, so pressure should be high, temperature should be low in this type of reaction. Similarly, some reactions are speeding up, or which increases the rate of reaction, that is known as catalyst. Catalyst can increase the rate of reaction or it decrease the rate of reaction. Increase means positive catalyst and decrease means negative catalyst. For example, platinum we are using 800 degrees Celsius, 4 ammonia, 5 oxygen, 4 anion and 6 water. This is very important reaction for method of preparation of nitric acid under Ostwald process in class 10th. So I have told you the method to balance it, very easy, 45-46. This is the method to balance, very very important reaction this is. And here platinum or manganese dioxide is acting as a catalyst which speeds the reaction. Similarly, the catalyst hydrogen peroxide, when MnO2 is used as a catalyst, it will decompose into water and O2. Okay, so this is normally hydrogen peroxide is helpful in getting oxygen by the use of catalyst MnO2. Okay, the negative catalyst means phosphoric acid. Phosphoric acid formula is H3PO4, retards the rate of decomposition of H4O2. The same decomposition rate will be retarded if you are adding phosphoric acid into that solution containing hydrogen peroxide. Similarly, the sound, some reactions produce sound, like we have told already, the reactions is propellant and moreover the explosives, these are producing sound. But some reaction, when the sound energy speeds up the reacting molecules, or input the sound energy to decompose the ethyne to carbon and hydrogen. So I would like to summarize this, that chemical reaction is what? Chemical reaction is that we are converting reactant into products, and there may be changes involved in that. New substance will be formed, new bonds will be formed, the reaction may be exothermic or endothermic, temperature will change the reaction, the color may change, it may form precipitates. Okay, and that may be involving some catalyst. The decomposition may take place in the sunlight present, decomposition takes place in the laxity present. So all these factors we have discussed. More we will study in the next part of the topic, where balancing of chemical reaction, reduction of chemical reaction will be the most important task. So thank you very much.